This is a demonstration of the HDMI to AV adapter harness that takes an HDMI input on this end and converts it to standard analog audio and video, red, white, and yellow RCAs on this end. It has an active video converter in the HDMI end, and what differentiates this cable from some of the other cheaper, extremely cheap adapter harnesses is that this is a true digital to analog video converter. It does require power, and it does indeed convert HDMI to AV. Cables that do not have this active converter built into it will not convert digital to analog. Now, since this cable does require power, it can either pull power through the device that's connected to the HDMI end, or you can plug in the USB plug on the other end of the cable, and it will pull power from the USB to power the digital converter on the other end. And the way this works is very straightforward and simple. Let's say for instance we want to hook up a phone. We can take our manufacturer's recommended adapter, and in this case let's use a Samsung S5. We'll use the Samsung adapter that is the female HDMI on one end, the Samsung mini USB connector on the other. We plug our HDMI into that end. We plug our phone into the other end. And let's say in this case we want to connect it to this radio. The radio actually comes with an adapter that converts the input jack on the face to female RCAs. Now this is a Carshow GM1210. Other radios that have standard female RCAs on the back will operate exactly the same way. You just plug in your RCAs, match them color to color, and in this case if we want to use our USB and power the cable from our USB end, we have a USB power source in the factory power plug. We plug that in down below, and now our phone is providing the video, but the USB is providing our power source. If we want to switch over to our input, we switch to AV1, and there is the output of our phone. And it will display on the radio, whether that's a TV, whether that's a car radio, rear monitor, etc. It'll play in the orientation that's on the phone. So for instance, let's say we want to bring up YouTube. If we leave the phone in the portrait mode, it will stay in portrait. If we flip it to horizontal or landscape mode, it'll switch over to landscape mode and vice versa. So if we want to keep it in a landscape orientation, we need to make sure that it stays in that orientation. So if we want to play our video, we just light it up. There you go. Anything that we see on the phone, we're now playing on the radio, and we've got audio and video in full synchronization. We're seeing exactly what we see on the phone, on the radio. So this is a great alternative to streaming YouTube, Netflix, anything that you've got, any video that you've got on the phone, any pictures, really anything that you can display on the phone can be streamed once the cable is plugged into the bottom of the device. if we wanted to hook up a Fire TV stick or Roku or Chromecast to our AV cable, we can do it the same way as we do with our phone or tablet. We just have to use slightly different connectors. In this case, let's say we have an Amazon Fire Stick, Fire TV Stick, I should say, that has a male HDMI, and our cable, since our cable has a male HDMI, we have to be able to plug these two together. We source a female-to-female HDMI connector. This came from Amazon. It was a whopping $4. We plug in the male Fire TV stick into one end. We plug our cable into the other end. And since the Fire TV stick does require a power source, we'll plug a USB to our USB cable to our USB power source we've already plugged our cable into. Plug it together. As soon as that receives power, it'll start to boot up, and you'll see that our output will come up on our display. And again, this can work on whether it's a radio, whether it's a drop-down TV screen in your car, whether it's a TV at home or a motel that doesn't have HDMI inputs. The conversion cable will do exactly the same thing on any display. Now, the Fire TV stick or any other device will require internet access. And we have, in this case, just activated that Wi-Fi hotspot on our phone. So we've paired up the Fire TV stick to the hotspot on our phone, and we get our internet access directly from the phone. So once we're all paired up, hooked up, the Fire TV stick is booted up, we can use the remote control that came with the Fire Stick exactly as we would use it sitting at home on the couch. So if we want to go in and, let's say, watch all the videos that we've got saved, or want to investigate our Amazon account, we can do exactly that with our remote control. As soon as it picks up our internet, we activate our video or playback, and there we go. We've got Amazon video streaming on our radio in our car.
All okay?
If you've got an Android device, and like in the case of my new Pixel, it doesn't have an adapter. It's got a USB-C type connector on the bottom that doesn't have any type of direct HDMI output from this phone. So the way that we're going to connect my Pixel or any other device that you'd like to run, let's say through a Google Chromecast, is essentially the same way as we would use it for a Fire Stick or a Roku. And that is taking our Chromecast, using our female-to-female HDMI connector, we plug it together, we plug that into our HDMI adapter cable, and then our power source, again, from our USB power in our cigarette lighter, we plug into our Google Chromecast. And now once that's all plugged together, we can set that aside in the console, wherever we want to go. We'll let our Chromecast boot up. And in our case, we're using a Wi-Fi hotspot in the vehicle. And that is paired to our phone and to the Google Chromecast module. So once the Google Chromecast gets booted up and paired up to the hotspot that's built into the car, then we can connect, let's say we want to do our YouTube playback, we can bring up our YouTube or any other, you know, any other thing that we can cast. We touch it, we hit our cast to Chrome, in this case Chromecast 7149, and now we've got streaming audio and video directly from our phone. And what's really cool about this is we can then go ahead and use our phone just like we want to do, just like for anything. You know, go back to using our phone as a standard phone. We can place phone calls. We can do anything we want to on our phone and still allow our playback to happen via our Gmail account and our Wi-Fi hotspot to our Google Chromecast.